Time now for a rink demo presented by Bauer. On the demo rink with Panger, got your goalie gear on. Yep. And we're going to talk about an evolution, the way guys want to handle the puck, create with their puck, that Jack Eichel does about as well as anyone. Now, Austin Matthews can do it. We see other guys be able to do this. But it is something that is very unique to players that are big and strong, because they're able to play the entire game with their hands about this far apart. No matter what they're doing, their hands maybe a foot, maybe 18 inches apart, over and over, over. Whether they're shooting, whether they're handling, whether they're checking, their hands are always this. They don't have to go down here to shoot it. They don't have to go down here to check someone. And because they're allowed to have their hands up here, it gives them a lot of versatility, gives them a little bit more time and space, and also some deception to the goaltender. So take a look at Jack Eichel as he's playing, and watch his hands as he goes through an entire game. Different situations. So from the point, now most guys have to take a slap shot, take multiple strides, really put their bottom hand down. He just leans on his stick with his hands 18 inches apart, flicks it with velocity. On a breakaway, protecting the puck, he has his hands very close together, but we know he can shoot the puck like this if he wants, so the goaltender has to respect the shot. Oh yeah, he can dangle with it as well with his hands close together. Attacking the blue line, hands close together. What do I want to do here? Hanger, what's he going to do? Pass or shoot? You tell me. You going to pass it back to Reinhardt?
No, he's going to shoot it.
Or he's going to shoot it. The pass is right there. The puck in his hands are exactly where they should be to pass it. Oh no, I'm going to try to go short side shelf. You're not sure because he can do either one with his hands in that position. How about stick checking? He doesn't have to move his feet, doesn't have to lean down and bend over. He can pick a stick from about 6 feet away and then make a pass off the boards. Again, under duress because he has the strength to make plays with his hands that 12 to 18 inches apart. It makes his game much easier, draws people towards him, and allows them to create offense. Nicely done by Jeff Skinner. Maybe one more. When you try to deke around someone, if you can carry a puck with your hands close together, it allows you to get that puck that much further away from the checker, so it's harder for them to get it off you when you have full possession. Jack Eichel, who's having a magnificent season, really becoming the leader in Buffalo, doing it all parts of the game, and you watch him play. I can't tell what he wants to do. Shoot, pass, even a backhand pass. Pull it to the other side, doesn't have to drop his hand. It's hidden underneath his hip because his hands are so close together, and he can still put enough velocity to get all the way across the front of the net for
a
play.
That's impressive.
It is impressive. Generally, it's got to do with strength, because when I played and I wanted to shoot the puck, now obviously I was not nearly as strong. I have a Jack Eichel stick, but that's where the comparisons end. So he wants to shoot the puck, he's got his hands like this. For me to shoot it, Panger, you know, you called my games, my hand would drop to here, then I could bend the shaft, and then I could release the puck. He's able to bend the shaft and blade from up here. I have a hard time doing it. I'm still 200 pounds, and I don't have the leverage and strength to do that. He can torque it. So Panger, now you've become the goaltender. I'm Jack Eichel. Maybe just explain to the people why this is difficult. When you see me with my hands like this, you know the highlights, you know he can do whatever he wants. What are you thinking when you see me with the puck right here? What am I going to do? Well, how do you decide as a goaltender? Why is that tough?
Okay, so number one, the goalie does look at the puck the whole time. But there are signals that can determine whether or not you're thinking pass or shoot. There's no question. A goaltender doesn't go take his eyes off the puck and go, where's his hands? But you can feel it because there's so much room there and his hands haven't lowered. So at this particular point, I'm probably expecting a pass more than I am a shot. And that's what makes Jack so successful. The goalies aren't quite ready for it. And the release is so quick because you're not sure if it's a pass or it's going to be a shot.
And that's just it. So I'm right here and you're thinking shot. And may just be a...
Yep.
You know, it may just be
a quick sweeper like that.
Quick sweeper like that.
Yep.
You see here, if you're thinking shot, it may be same exact place. It's a play to the back door, and you have to guess. That kind of subterfuge, some kind of hiding what he wants to do, is part of what makes him so good. Now, it's great to try it. It's why little kids, if they can play with longer sticks, they probably should, because this offers that same kind of advantage. But just the strength required, not just in your wrist, but in your core, in your legs, to be able to bend the puck and handle it like that. I don't know if it's a lot of wrist curls or what, or maybe it's just natural, but he has it, Austin Matthews have it, and it is a real advantage.
Johnny, just looking at the video too, the game is played with such stick on puck, defending-wise.
That's the battle now.
And for a defenseman to be able to reach out and maybe overcommit to him while they're trying to defend, now he can toe drag it, and now he's got 8 feet, 12 feet that he can dance by a defenseman if they get lured into trying to go
right,
stick
Panger,
on puck.
Knock your goalie stick, become a defenseman for us. This is exactly what we're talking about. So now if Panger wants to try to cover me, now he wants to go stick on puck. If my hands are lower, if I'm not Jack Eichel, I got my hands here. So now it allows me to, I have to get that much closer to you to handle it. I don't have that much room to go. I'm quite close. You can engage with the stick, you can engage with the body, because I'm here. Now, if I'm Jack Eichel, I'm way out here.
Now you get lured.
And I have all that space, that much further away. So if you get a sense in actual feet, so if the foot, with Jack Eichel with his hands here, get your stick out of the way real quick, I can control this on the blue line, standing with my feet here. If I was playing, if Mike Johnson was playing, not with Jack Eichel's stick, but with my own, I would have to have the puck probably here. That's 18 inches closer to the defender because I'm not capable of handling it with confidence at the end of my range of motion. He's able to do that. Same thing when you have the puck. You talk about stick battles, exactly. So again, if I'm going to check, Mike Johnson's going to check Panger, I got to get here, right here, to get under his stick. I got to be able to lean, get my stick down. Jack Eichel can do it from here. Again, it's an 18-inch gap, 2-foot gap, but those feet add up. Those feet add to possession, add to time, add to chances, and that really makes the difference when you're trying to protect it or play without it and get it back. We saw the clip of him popping Barkov's stick and then making a pass with his hands almost together like a golf club.
By the way, Barkov's pretty strong on his stick.
Maybe yeah, he's not bad either. The last one we have is, as I'm coming down on you, if I want to just throw it outside, okay? I'm out here.
Yeah.
I got all this room.
Yeah.
If Mike Johnson's playing. Is that much closer?
Defending-wise, I'm...
Jack Eichel's out here.
Yeah.
If you want to reach.
So if I want to reach on you.
Uh-oh. Now we're in trouble. Yeah. Jack Eichel has all the tools. We know he's incredibly talented, but we also know he's incredibly strong. His ability to play with his hands that close together makes his game that much better.
Great stuff there. The game is a gift. Visit your local retailer or Bauer.com for great holiday hockey gifts.